Okay, here we have a homemade interseeder. It's set up on 22-inch rows. My brother Will and I built it. It's started out, the main frame is it's an old 8-row 36 row crop cultivator that we took all the units off and used the bar and the gauge wheels off of it. It's called a three-point system that raises and lowers by a universal lifting system that all three-point equipment would have. It's run off tractor hydraulics. We just back up to it with the control in the tractor. It hooks up to it automatically and set the locks, and it's mounted. And then we just hooked up the hydraulic hoses for the fan. And as we were building this, we really wanted to make it a no-till interseeder. We'd looked at so many that used an old double disc drill off a drain drill or a seed deflector type of a thing where it was a broadcast better. We just felt that it would be way more advantageous to use this thing as a no-till unit. So we found a neighbor that had a 30-foot drill that he took off every other unit to make a 15-inch bean drill out of it, and he let us borrow these units. So we had to mount another bar behind the main bar. The mounting procedure for this no-till unit needed to be on a 4x4 pipe, so then we had to marry a 4x4 pipe to the 6x8 regular frame that the cultivator came with, which wasn't that big a deal to make the hookup work with the 4x4 pipe. They're way heavier than we guessed they would have been. So we put one row on it, took it to the field, used the GPS in the tractor, and set that one row unit to make sure that everything was in a fit in between 22-inch rows. Because when you need a corn that's knee high or above, you just don't realize how little of space you have to be running planter units and stuff up. We were pretty confident then to put the rest of the rows on. These here units are John Deere no-till units. We had a Valmar unit that a friend of ours had on a field cultivator for putting down granular chemical years ago. We took that and mounted that on here also then. The nice thing about these Valmars or Gandys, whatever, they're pretty accurate too. This has got like a 13-speed gearbox with a 2-speed drive chain on the wheel, so it's fairly good range of calibration you can do with it. It's an air fan delivery also, which was what we were looking for. The only thing we really had to buy much was the hose. We had to make a couple trips to Fargo to get the right hose that would join up to the row unit plus to the metering system on the bottom of the box. It's set up for 24 rows and it holds 20 bushels of seed. So yeah, perfect for what we were doing. We're only putting down about 20 to 30 pounds an acre anyway on the interseeding. These little hoses here feed the air that blows through underneath the seed tube and just grabs the seed that gravity flows down into the seed tube, shoots it straight through to these lawn hoses in the back. They turn over and go into the seed coulter, into the no-till seed unit down here. The wheel over there is the drive wheel that meters the seed, and there's a transmission up on the front left side up there that to set the meter speed. It's chain drive from the ground. As far as accuracy and simplicity, it's about as simple as you could get, you know, and it started out as just a kind of a drying on a napkin in the garage when we first started with it. So, and it all worked out just fine. It worked perfect and calibrated really nice the first time we used it. We were lucky when we got done, the drive wheel in the back is a little bit wider than we wanted, and to make that fit down 22-inch rows, we had to really trim on the drive shaft and build the deflector and stuff for the drive chain to make that fit down. But overall, we got lucky with how the whole construction of it went, and it's very accurate and does a good job. And being it's no-till and puts that seed right in the ground through the trash and the seed soil to contract, our cover crop's been coming out of the ground in, you know, less than a week, and you can start to roll the beans and the radishes. So, and Will brought up a great point. With the single disc system on here, it hardly has any soil disturbance because we don't interseed until after we sprayed our herbicide on our corn. So we're not reseeding any weeds really. We're having very little disturbance in between the rows for the interseeding for any new weed development or anything. Because I mean, this whole cover crop thing and this and that, we're desperately trying to fight resistant Roundup weeds and stuff anyway. You know, and weed control is huge. We've had a few neighbors rent it to interseed too. So it's been around, it's been out to Howard's and it's been to Thompson's. It's been to a couple neighbors' places, you know. We're not advertising any custom work or anything like that with it, but if neighbors have wanted to use it, they've came and hooked onto it and used it.